I recently read, I think in the Harvard Business Review, that about 60% of America is dual career couples. Yeah. What advice would you have based on your own journey of having navigated a dual career couple and made it two really flourishing careers? What advice would you have for women who are in that middle management, early management roles where, you know, the dual careers really kick off and now they've got to make hard trade-offs, hard choices around whose career takes precedence at any given point in time? The need or the urge to have it all at a given point in time. All of those things pulling at you, yeah. What advice would you have for them?
Number one, it's you cannot have it all. You just cannot. And so why beat yourself up? Once you accept that, and that's very hard for us to accept that, because back to this whole discussion we had earlier about being perfectionist, you want to be the perfect mother. So if your kid
isn't
doing...
And when you say you cannot have it all, just to clarify, you mean you cannot have it all at the same time?
No, but that's what I'm coming to. You cannot have it all. You can have all of it some of the time, you can have some of it all of the time. You cannot have all of it all of the time. It just doesn't work.
Right. It's hard. It's
because
it's,
no, it was a fundamental shift in thinking. Once you accept that construct, then you make unique trade-offs based on the day, based on, I mean, I miss my daughter's 9 days of being with chickenpox because I hadn't had chickenpox and I couldn't afford to get chickenpox because I was in the middle of a major restructuring. So I kind of would stand outside her door and see it. That was a trade-off I made. But then on the flip side is I then gave up an entire life of a certain way to be home at 4 o'clock every single day that she was available. Different points in time. Did it have costs? Absolutely. But was that the right decision? I don't even think that's the right question.
Yeah.
It was the best decision. It was
you
the
got
perfect
to take it
decision
in context and,
for that
right.
moment of time, for all the information and the knowledge and the mm-hmm. thinking I had. I really want all of the techniques of introspection to be focused on people getting to their best self. And when women's power is unleashed as their best self, there is no stopping them. One of my clients said to me early on, actually, I'll never forget this moment, when he said to me, you know, Chandrika, I want to say to you, in the meeting, the intellectual power of your work, of what you have to say, is completely dwarfed by your style of how you say it. You just don't seem confident. He said, and now my managers take you that seriously. Because he says, I see what you're saying is good, but by the time you've sort of apologized for it and done it in your way, no one's really listening to you. You just need to hear this. You know, it was a crushing blow to me. But I also knew that nobody was taking me seriously in these meetings. And I started to think about it. Not that I could fix it overnight. Let's start with something small we can fix. And picking up on your theme about curiosity, the one sort of the nickname for me used to be Chandrika Chatterbox because I asked questions all the time. Whoever came, I would ask questions. And in fact, when I came to America for the first time, this is not the tradition here. You don't just meet random people and ask them deep questions about everything, personal, professional, and everything. I just love asking questions. And that became a big gift to me because I learned so much, a lot of random pieces of information, but lots of important things, lots of lessons and learning.